The moment you've all been waiting for. Will silver and gold take off in 2024? You have questions. We have all the answers. But what is the biggest news story right now in the silver market in particular? And what is it telling us about where silver can go next year? But it's the moment you've all been waiting for, because we're joined by our good friend CoinShop Chris. He's going to help us break all this down. Where will we be sitting with the silver price next year, right now, 6 months from now? And we're going to discuss this big breaking story that's tearing apart the silver market. CoinShop Chris, welcome to Ron's Basement.
How are you doing, Ron? Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to all of you is out there. Before we get started, Ron. We're at the time of recording this video, Ron, you text me, we're at 30,840 subscribers. Our goal is 31,000 subscribers by end of the year. If it's not subscribed yet, please subscribe so we can hit this goal. I would greatly appreciate everybody doing that.
That's awesome, Chris. And you know what? It's me and you, but the most important person on this video is the viewer. So I want to ask you right now, when you look out one calendar year from today, it's December 23rd, Christmas Eve, 2023. Where do you see the silver price, Chris?
Ron, like I said last week, we could be looking at between $70 silver, maybe 60-ish. I will back that off just a bit. Between 50 and 60, it could really get to 70 by the end of next year.
You think so?
If everything goes what I'm thinking is going to happen, look, we got the banks, and they're in trouble, Ron. You know, they're in trouble in February and March. They own big money back to the government. They don't have it. Where are they going to get that from? People are broke. They're not spending. They're only spending what they need to. People are going in debt right now, Ron. I was just at the grocery store today. Couldn't find a parking spot. They're all putting on credit cards. At some point, those credit cards are going to be maxed out. And they're not, where are they going to get the money then? Where?
So where did you say you went earlier? The Ding Dong store?
No, I went to Aldi's. And the place was a madhouse. Just a few hours ago. We're seeing at 1 o'clock Eastern time here, just about. 2 hours ago, I was there, Ron. The place was a madhouse.
Yeah. Well, it'll be interesting to see how everything plays out next year. There are so many moving pieces. It's impossible for anyone to pin them all down at once. But I mean, do you think that it's safe to say that a lot of these moving pieces, you know, we don't need all of them to fall into place, but if just a handful fall into place, they could be very supportive factors for the silver price, one of which is inflation. And I'm of the opinion that right now we're actually experiencing some deflation, which is scaring the pants off Jerome Powell at the Federal Reserve, which may explain why just a week and a half ago, he came out with some very loose, dovish indicators in his speech and in their press release that indicate that we could see rate cuts sooner as opposed to later. And I think that the other pieces are in place right now that could result in a fast spike in inflation next year. And I'm almost done talking, Chris. I think when that inflation comes back again, people are going to freak, like the average people, right? The people that aren't stacking silver and gold right now, they're going to remember what happened in 21 and 22, and they're going to be looking for ways to protect their wealth that could be silver. And that could lead into what you're calling for $60 or $70 silver. And I appreciate you asking me also what my prediction for silver is for next year.
What's your prediction, Ron? $25?
$48 an ounce on December 23rd, 2024.
$48. Everybody write that down. $48 for Ron. No, you're absolutely right, Ron. You know, we got record debt in this country. You know, we're at, 30, 5 trillion almost, 36 trillion. I can't remember what the heck it was. The last time I looked, it was 34 trillion. You know, we can't keep paying 7% on interest rates. And, you know, this country is not bringing enough money in. There's not enough people working to bring this, you know, everything's doubled. You know, we can go back to the Home Alone movie in a little bit here on. But I really want to give you some credit here on. You know, yes, you are absolutely, we're going to have high inflation. The BRICS are getting together. They're paying oil and other, other goods to other dollars. That's saying the dollar back home, Ron. These countries don't want the U.S. dollar. When these dollars do come back home, we're going in hyperinflation, and people are going to, the people who don't have silver and gold are going to say, what the heck happened?
Yeah,
and it's going to happen overnight.
And I think a real simple way to look at it is if you just look domestically at the United States, our financial condition, our monetary condition, our political condition, our social condition, it's pretty frightening, unfortunately. And then if you zoom out and look at it from a worldwide geopolitical perspective, all those things you mentioned, right? The BRICS, the bifurcation, the de-dollarization that's going on. Any way you slice it or dice it, unfortunately, it's not looking like a very nice situation for the United States heading into the coming years. We don't like it. We live here. We didn't necessarily directly create it, but we're not going to stick our heads in the sand and act like it's not happening.
Now, you've had a lot of people this past year on your channel, and one of them I really enjoyed the most was Andy Shechtman. And I'm going to use his little bit when he says, little by little by little, then boom, all at once, it's going to blow up, Ron. He's absolutely right. He's absolutely right. That's what's going to happen.
Yep. And maybe, go ahead.
And, you know, and this is why we're not trying to push anybody to buy silver or gold. You know, we're not buying anything. We're converting. You know, and John, you know, you were the first one out on YouTube talking about the female stackers this year. First one. Congratulations
on that
one.
The lady stackers. June 14th is International Women's Silver Day, by the way.
And you were the first one, as Pat Holland said, you were the first one to take on the state-by-state gold and silver laws. Congratulations on that. People are starting, other channels are starting to pick that up.
So and we are, Chris, let me interject. So we, and I'm going to say we because you're a big part of this as well. We're trailblazers and women in silver and trailblazers and getting the word out on YouTube, alternative media, about the fact that the states, one by one across the country, are enacting some forms of legal tender legislation. I read the other night, like 25 states considered some form of legal tender legislation in 2023 alone. What does that tell us?
That tells half of the states are awake. The other 25, they're not awake yet. But I think we're going to get there one by one. And, you know, I would like also point this out, Ron. When we were talking early this summer, spring, whenever it was, with the coin shops and the banks shutting down coin shops, bank account, pawn shops, bank account, a lot of other YouTubers blew this up as a mountain. And I kind of advised you, I'll take some credit here too, Ron, with you. I said, let's just not blow this one up and let's see what happens. And, you know, about a week or two later, it all went away. You know, we handled that one right, Ron, and I commend you for doing the same thing with me. We handled that one right.
Well, at least we handled one thing right. And I want to remind you something, Chris, if you don't mind. Later in the video, we have some earth-shattering news about silver in particular.
Absolutely. But you didn't blow this one up, and I appreciate for you doing that. And, you know, we just tried to bring the viewers, you know, facts, a little bit of knowledge that we do have, and we try to have some fun.
Yeah.
And that's why, you know, you're a little bit different than most. You know, and that's what we all love you for, Ron. So you have a heck of a year, Ron. Congratulations.
This, Well, thank you, Chris. I appreciate you saying that. This is nothing without the viewer, right? Right now it's me and you, but the most important person is the person who's joining us from their basement or their family room, or maybe they're driving their car. Who knows, right? But it's not RonTube. It's not ChristTube. It is YouTube. And our viewers, our community, has made all this possible. They really have. I mean, if nobody ever joined and we get so much support and great input and insight, I think it's great. I'm going to give you a lot of credit as well. You've been an instrumental part in helping us, but our viewers have been a big, big part of this as well. So thank you. And thank you to the person who's joining us still right now. I mean, it's important. What we're talking about can be some very scary and difficult subjects, and you know, we just want to be prepared. We want to be we don't want to live in fantasy land. I think we can say that about you, about me, and about this person who's joining us. Like, we're willing to look at the tough facts because we want to protect ourselves, we want to protect our family. And I think a lot of us share that common experience where we started to learn about what was really going on in the world, what's really going on in the monetary system, that silver and gold became like, it was obvious. It was like the this gut feeling, this attraction, like silver and gold can protect us. And it's a lot of fun and the people are great too. You did some comparison shopping this week, looking at silver dollars. Junk silver, constitutional silver, 90% silver. Do you care to share with us what you discovered when you went out there in the World Wide Web and looked around at what different companies have to offer?
Yeah, the piece dollars, you know, I mean, there's a lot of good deals out there right now on the piece dollars, Ron. And this, the first one I'm going to mention, Ron, is not going to be compared apples for apples, but it's going to be very, very close. Money Metals had them for $27.75 each, but they define them as calls. And if someone don't know what a call means, it could be the dates worn off, the back where it says piece worn off, holes, big scratches in them, big gashes in them. That would be defined as a call. Atmex and SD Bullion had them for $26.99 each. The price, the quality was 1-19 on them. JM Bullion came in at $26.75, and they all defined them as very good plus grade. Pinback came in a very good grade plus grade at $25 even, Ron, from 1-19 count two. So there's $2. So they come in 2-20. They're a little bit cheaper if you buy them in 2-20, of course. That'll be the next lower price. You know, $2 that, you know, at $20 dollars here on, that's $40 savings that Pinback is offering us. I mean, where can you not, why would you buy anywhere else? We say this single week, Ron. We're here to save the viewer, your viewer, money. And that's all.
And that's why I am sponsored by Pembex, because I believe that you want to get the most metal for your money. And whether you're looking at sovereign coins, bars, or 90% silver, like you demonstrated for us today, what I found on my own before I was sponsored by Pembex was that their prices were always the best. And I was getting the exact same product from them that I could get from other sources. So, you know, I think that if our viewer is interested in looking at some silver, some gold, or some platinum, I always recommend do your own research, do your own, you know, your own due diligence in the process. You want to make sure you're comfortable with the company that you're dealing with, that you can trust them. You want to make sure that they have the product that you want, that the selection's there. And then, of course, what's always very important to me after I've satisfied those two requirements is you want to get the best price. And it seems like Pembex always delivers there. Let's talk about this leads us right into this massive news that we have in the silver market, because a lot of new stackers, a lot of people, you know, we talked earlier about this prospect of crazy inflation. in 2024, and that might just be the catalyst that wakes up a large number of people who are asleep right now in the United States to the fact that they need to do something to protect their money, right? They've been through the inflation of 21, 22. If it hits again, it's going to be the old, you know, fool me once, shame on you, but they aren't going to want to get fooled again. And they're going to want to go somewhere that they trust initially to buy gold, to buy silver. And a lot of these people, they don't know who the big online bullion dealers are, the big trustworthy names out there, right? The Pembexes, the SD Bullions, the EPMEX, a lot of them trust a company like Costco, wouldn't you say, Chris?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, if you don't know what you're, I don't want to say you don't know what you're doing, but if you're not into the market and you're seeing this come up on Costco's website, people trust Costco for everything.
So we got some big news in the silver market. We know Costco sold $100 million worth of gold over the last 3 months, which is a pretty significant number, but they just started selling American Silver Eagles. And lo and behold, number one, that's great news for anyone who's in the silver sector, because Costco is a big, trusted, respected, a lot of people, millions of people trust Costco, and they know that they're getting a good value when they buy something from Costco. And now that Costco is selling American Silver Eagles, that adds a whole new segment of people who can gain access to silver. But you know what's shocking about all this, Chris?
It's going to go through the roof. That's what's shocking about it.
And it did go through the roof, because just like the gold that they put on their website and is pretty much immediately gobbled up, the Silver Eagles they put onto their website were pretty much immediately purchased by their customers all throughout the United States.
That shows more, you know, this goes back to right to Andy Shechtman. Little by little by little, he says, then boom, all at once. Yep. And we're going to wake up some Monday morning, Ron, and it probably will happen in 2024. And it's probably going to happen somewhere between late February to the beginning of April, where we're going to have another rush on silver and gold. People are going to start getting their tax money back, and a lot of that money is going to go right into silver and gold, and you're not going to be able to find it again.
Yeah, and those Costco people that are now buying silver as well, right, a whole new segment of the market, you can't blame them, because, you know, maybe they remember back to 1990 when they would go through the checkout line and maybe spend a lot less money, as opposed to now groceries are a lot more expensive. It makes me think, are there any examples you can think of, Chris, where like groceries have gotten more expensive since 1990?
Ron, I got a perfect example. And since it's Christmas time, Ron, we're gonna revisit the Home Alone. I know we did this last week, but if this is one section of the video that you share with anybody, clip this and right to the end of this now, share it with one person that's not awoke yet. Now, when Kevin McAllister went to the grocery store, Ron, by himself, all those groceries cost $19.83. Back in 1990, Ron, silver was roughly around $5.22 an ounce. So you would say you would need about 4 ounces of silver for that same, for those goods that he bought. Last year, Ron, those same groceries he bought was $44.70. Last year's average silver spot price now, we're not talking about the premiums on top of it, was $18.78, Ron. Again, you add that to 4 ounces, you would have $75.12. Well, you can always buy double the stuff he bought with 4 ounces of silver. Speed it up today, Ron. 33 years later, Ron, silver spot is roughly around $24.57 an ounce. Times that by four, you get $98.28, but the cost would cost you $72.28. Silver has held its value. Gold has held its value. People like David Ramsey, who calls it a pet rock, well, I think he lives under the rock. So, I mean,
so let me just make sure I'm clear on this. In 1990, the groceries that Kevin McAllister bought would have cost about 4 ounces of silver. If we fast forward to today, that exact same amount of groceries, the exact same products, would only cost about 3 ounces of silver. So I'd say silver more than held its value over the last, right, whatever it was, 33
absolutely
years.
Absolutely. If you times it by the cost, yes, you would still have about, yeah, it would cost you about 3 ounces of silver versus 33 years ago, Ron.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Now, Chris, what everybody's really been waiting for, the 30-day numbers. Can you share those with us?
30-day numbers? Yes, I can, Ron. Okay. Silver, over the last 30 days, Ron, was up 78 cents, or up 3.30%. Gold was up $71.70, or up 3.60%. Platinum did very well, up $49.20, or up 5.29%. Your Bitcoin was up $7,938.67, or up 22.717%. And oil is starting to go back up. We're still down, but we're only down $3.61 per barrel, or down 4.68%. And the silver to gold ratio this week, Ron, is 84.36.
So you're telling me that if I want to trade silver for gold, I'm going to have to take 4 tubes of American Silver Eagles and another 4 ounces, and I can take those 4 tubes and 4 individual coins and trade that for 1 ounce of gold.
And maybe about $6, Ron.
Wow. Wow. That's why we say silver is the most undervalued asset in the entire world.
Absolutely. And that's what, yep, I continue to stack, Ron. And I know a lot of viewers like silver over gold at this time. Not saying gold is a bad thing, you know, but silver is half of its all-time high.
Yeah. Well, and you said gold, that a year from now, it's going to be somewhere between $60 and $70 an ounce. So, what could go wrong?
We will see if I'm right or wrong, Ron. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm batting in the wind here. But with going back 33 years with the Home Alone movie, what's going to happen the next 33 years, Ron? What's going to happen next year? What's going to happen 2 years from now?
Yeah.
Just last year's average cost of silver was $18.78. We're seeing at $24.57 this year.
Yeah. So now you ruined me for Christmas movies, by the way, Chris. I appreciate that. We were watching Christmas Vacation last night, and there's a scene in that movie where Chevy Chase takes his brother-in-law, and they're at a Walmart, and the brother-in-law is like buying dog food and stuff and putting it on the cart. And the whole time I'm looking at the prices thinking, I wonder how much prices have gone up. I wonder how much silver has been. So I'd like to thank you personally for now ruining all of my Christmas movies as I'm trying to do silver price comparisons.
Well, Ron, when you buy the light bulbs, make sure you put them on top of the dog food. Yeah. Merry Christmas, Ron. Merry Christmas, everybody.
I know you've gotten yourself in some legal trouble in the past by sticking a couple Barbie dolls in the bottom of the cart and then piling the heavy dog food bags on top of it, hoping the checkout lady wouldn't see it, right?
Those were the My Little Ponies for you, my friend.
All right. Merry Christmas. If you guys want to help support Coin Shop Chris, there's a link in this video to his PayPal account. He does all this out of the kindness of his heart. He can't pry a penny out of my frugal persona. But like I said, there's a PayPal link down below. Chris, as always, on behalf of myself, but most importantly, the viewer who's joined us through this entire video, thank you. Happy holidays to you and everyone. And we'll count on seeing you next week.
Absolutely, Ron. I'll be here. I might even have some bells on.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Ron. See you next week. Merry Christmas, everybody.